WROI News, connecting you with your local, statewide, and national leaders. This is WROI News.
WROI, it's time now to take a look at your local news. News today is brought to you by Rochester Greenhouse. Send a fresh cut flower bouquet today and make someone's day. And by Wendy's Restaurant, 2340 South Main, Rochester. Wendy's is way better than fast food. It's Wendy's. Currently sitting at 73 degrees under sunny skies here in downtown Rochester. We'll take a look at your full weather forecast a little bit later on in your news. The Rochester Fire Department, Every County Fire, and Argus and Mentone all were on the scene of a fire Saturday at Rochester Iron and Metal at 1342 East Lucas Street. The call came in at about 5 p.m. and firefighters were at the scene all night. Fire departments from surrounding counties were put on alert and the Peru Fire Department was called up to cover Rochester. The smoke was seen as far south as southern Miami County and in Wabash and Logansport. WROI spoke with Rochester Fire Chief Tom Butler, who said the smoke was more of an annoyance than a health threat to the surrounding areas.
Smoke is never good. I thought the precautions, and we put an announcement out over Nixle to self-evacuate if you felt the need or to shelter in place, to stay inside and with your windows and doors shut and sit it out. Again, you never know what's in there, but, I mean, basically, you know, the black smoke was probably from some petroleum-based products, tires, rubber hoses, that kind of thing. Shortly after our arrival, the smoke changed. We were able to cool it down. I mean, there still was smoke. It still smelled. But that was the advice, you know, that made the most sense.
Butler went on to thank the community for the support they received during and after the fire.
I would like to thank our community. We live in a great place. I've got flats of water here. People donated. I have donuts. I have cookies. Someone brought in Sloppy Joe and buns for us. We had pizzas, Kentucky Fried Chicken, Taco Bell.
The fire remains under investigation, though Butler says the cause may never be found. Woodlawn Hospital CEO John Alley was our guest on the WROI Hospital Report. As the warmer weather approaches, it's time to think about renovation projects, and Alley told us they are looking at upgrading patient rooms.
It was put on hold about 5-6 years ago because I wanted us to have funds set aside so that I didn't have to borrow money to do this renovation. So we've kind of called the architects and said, hey, can you get those plans out? Let's dust them off. Let's see where we're at on that. I'm guessing there's going to be some changes from 5 years ago when we first looked at it, just because the regulations change. And so whatever those are, we'll have to update those plans.
Cost change, too.
Cost. Sure. I'm guessing the cost has gone up quite a bit. You know, we're going to start that process right now. I would like for us to see if we can't get that renovation started third quarter 2019.
Okay. Alley went on to say it would not be a short project.
It's going to take a while, I think, to get everything in place. And it's not going to be just a short renovation, because if we're going to redo all the rooms, I can only do about three at a time. So we'll take three out of service. So it could be, you know, 60, 90 days that those three rooms out of service, put them back, take another three rooms out. So when you start looking across the number of rooms we have, that could be a couple years before that whole project would be completed.
And again, that was Woodlawn Hospital CEO John Alley. City Hall will be closing at 11:30 a.m. on Friday, May 4th, due to a computer network upgrade. This only affects City Hall and the utility office. No other department will be affected. We'll be back with a look at your full weather forecast after this.
If you're planning a wedding in the coming year, Rochester Greenhouse, 412 West 11th Street, offers free consultation and offers the most creative and beautiful wedding flowers. Stop by and refresh your home with new cash and carry spring flowers, silk arrangements, and gifts. Next door, Brooch Boutique has received all the great looks and transitional fashions for spring in sizes small to plus. There's new arrivals every day. So shop Rochester Greenhouse and Brooch Boutique. Two stores, twice the shopping fun.
And now for something deliciously different from Wendy's. Wendy's Double Stack is still an option in the 4-for-4. With a quarter pound of fresh beef, four nuggets, fries, and a drink. That's a deal so good it should not exist. Like how owls shouldn't be able to turn their heads all the way around.
Whew,
Wouldn't like that deal.
The 4 for $4 with your choice of a double stack, junior bacon cheeseburger, or crispy chicken BLT. A deal so great, it's impossibly good. But not for long.
At participating Wendy's for a limited time, meal includes four-piece chicken nuggets, small fries, and a drink. Fresh beef available in the contiguous U.S., Alaska, and Canada. Not valid in Alaska and Hawaii.
And again, we are sitting at 73 degrees under sunny skies here in downtown Rochester. Culver is at 72. The Grissom Aeroplex is at 72 as well. We continue to see sunny skies the rest of the afternoon. Tonight will be mostly clear, and we have a low around 48. Tomorrow, we see sunny skies, a high near 80. We do have a southwest wind at 10 to 20 miles an hour and could see some wind gusts up around 30 miles an hour. Tomorrow night, partly cloudy and a low around 60 with a south wind around 15 miles per hour with some wind gusts up around 25 miles per hour. On Wednesday, we see a chance of showers and thunderstorms, a high near 80. It will be breezy, and we see some wind gusts up around 30 miles an hour. We have a low around 65. On Thursday, showers likely and possibly a thunderstorm, a high near 77, and a low around 61. And then on Friday, showers likely before 8 a.m., then becoming mostly cloudy, a high near 73, and a low around 51. Again, 72 degrees at the Grissom Aeroplex, 72 in Culver, 73 here in downtown Rochester. And this has been a look at the forecast for Rochester and all of North Central Indiana. The news today was brought to you by Rochester Greenhouse, corner of 11th and Fulton Streets. They are your full-service hometown florist. And by Wendy's. Wendy's hamburgers are made fresh, never frozen, now open late. For WROI News, I'm Paul Zartman.
Do you have the WROI News Tip of the Week? When you see or hear news happening, call 223-6059. If you have the top tip of the week, we'll pay you $10. That's 574-223-6059. 223-6059.